नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू आर हेल एंड हार्टी, टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ एंड योर स्टडीज। माय नेम इज ज्योत्सना एंड आई एम फ्रॉम एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट चंडीगढ़। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट टुडेज सेशन, आई वुड जस्ट लाइक टू आस्क यू वेरी सिंपल थिंग। वी आर ऑल गिवन असाइनमेंट्स, हाउ डू वी डू इट? इट्स वेरी ईजी फॉर द किड्स टुडे। फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू हु आर वॉचिंग दिस प्रोग्राम राइट नाउ, इफ योर टीचर टेल्स यू टू प्रिपेयर an assignment on modes of irrigation, what would you do? You would go search on the internet, download the photographs and add some text to the document file, get the prints and submit it to your teacher. But things were not that easy when we were in school. We had to refer to many books, write it all by our own hands and then submit it to our teachers. Of course, the assignments you are giving are very good. They are very clean, clear and presentable. Of course, they have probably better content than the ones we had, because you refer to many sources at one point and we could refer to only those sources which we had access to. So how this entire thing has evolved? We had hardbound books we referred to. You have digital media. Nothing has actually changed, but the world has become a global village today. International writers are just a click away. That's what is happening. The print. That's what we are going to do today. It's chapter number 5, print culture and the modern world. So let's get going. We are dividing this entire chapter into two different videos. Today, we shall be taking up the historical part, how it has evolved. In our next video, we shall be taking up how it has brought an impact to the society. So, let's take up the first part today. When the art of printing was unknown, only a few people were able to read and write, and all book knowledge was confined to church officials and to those who were teachers in the universities of those days. During the period when printing was invented, there was a general desire for learning throughout Europe, and this invention, while it made books cheaper, also made it necessary to possess at least the ability to read. So in order to gain knowledge, people began to learn to read, and in order to communicate with others who were not within talking distance, they were compelled to learn to write. Thus, printing is important because it caused knowledge to be spread among the many instead of keeping it confined to the few. It is true that in the early days of the art, few people in comparison with the number today knew how to read or write. But since that time, education for all has been spreading until at the present time, a certain amount of schooling is compulsory for all the children in this country. The development of printing has made it possible for us to use our ability to read, because books on hundreds of different subjects, magazines and newspapers are published at prices that are within reach of most of us. The development of public libraries where books may be drawn out free of charge is also the result of the invention of printing, which has made possible the rapid production of many copies of single books. Thus, knowledge has been placed within the reach of all who care to gain possession of it. Science, art, and literature are no longer the mysteries they were in bygone days, and the news of current happenings all over the world is handed to us almost within a few hours after their occurrence through the medium of the daily newspaper. The monthly and the weekly magazines and the newspapers not only print the news of the day, but they also publish stories and articles discussing a wide range of topics, which are written in such a manner as to make them intelligible to all. The invention of printing therefore has aided in the movement to spread knowledge among the many. In the old days, before printing and some of other modern inventions were discovered, people in one community knew very little about those in other places because the means of communication were lacking. This resulted in ignorance and lack of understanding between people. The situation is quite different today. Due to books, magazines and the newspapers, among other things, which were made possible by invention of printing, people in one part of the world can make themselves understood by the others. Thus, they are brought closer together and are able to make use of all the things which are devised or invented and thought of in all parts of the world. The members of this industry call printing the art preservative of all arts. This is due to the fact that with the aid of invention, we are able to make permanent records of current events and of the progress that is being made in all lines of endeavor from day to day. Thus, we are able to hand down to future generations accurate and trustworthy accounts of our activities, in contrast with the distant past when most records were transmitted by the word of mouth. The people who are engaged in the work of printing or the preservation of these accounts are therefore rendering an important service to the community. Do you know which was the first book ever to be commercially printed? It was a 42-line version of Bible, known as Gutenberg Bible. It was printed in 1450s and started the printing revolution and the print culture, which became very significant in the history of mankind. So, let's find out more. It is actually difficult for us to imagine a world without printed matter. We find evidence of print everywhere around us, in books, journals, newspapers, prints of famous paintings, and also in everyday things like theater programs, official circulars, calendars, diaries, advertisements, cinema posters, at street corners. We read printed literature, see printed images, follow the news through newspapers, and track public debates that appear in print. We take for granted the world of print and often forget that there was a time before print. We may not realize that print itself has a history, which has, in fact, shaped our contemporary world. So, what is this history? When did print literature begin to circulate? How has it helped create the modern world? In the very first picture given in your books, we can see bookmaking before the age of print. This is from Akhlaq-i-Nasiri in 1595. This is a royal workshop in the 16th century, much before the printing began in India. You can see the text being dictated, written, and illustrated. The art of writing and illustrating by hand was important in the age before print. Think about what happened to those forms of art with the coming of printing machines. So, let's take up the journey of print culture. First and foremost came oral culture, the orality, the spoken words. Then, the manuscripts. After that, the print, and now the electronic. So, let's take it from where it all had begun. The oral culture. Oral culture was all that existed. It gradually found the need to store what was said for long periods of time and slowly developed scribble culture. Scribble culture, being inaccurate and tedious at best, developed into print culture. Each segment is rich with its own effect on the world. Scribble culture, defined by the written or physical conveying of the ideas, is important to understand in achieving a grasp on the unfolding of print culture itself. Scholars disagree over when scribble culture developed. Walter Ong argues that scribble culture cannot exist until an alphabet is created and a form of writing standardized. On the other hand, D.F. McKenzie argues that even communicative notches on a stick or structure represents text and therefore scribble culture. Ong suggests that the scribble culture is defined by an alphabet. McKenzie says that the key to scribble culture is non-verbal communication. which can be accomplished in more ways than using an alphabet. These two views give rise to the importance of print culture. In scribal culture, procuring document was a difficult task, and the documentation would then be limited to the rich only. Ideas are difficult to spread amongst large group of people over large distances of land, not allowing to effective dissemination of knowledge. Scribal culture also deals with the large levels of inconsistencies. It was always considered that the oldest document was the most accurate, as it had been copied the least. In the process of copying documents, many times the meaning became changed and the words different. Reliance on the written text of the time was never exceedingly strong. Over time, a great need for reliable, quickly reproduced, and relatively inexpensive means of distributing written text arose. Scribal culture transforming into print culture was only replicated in manners of written text. Same is the form of probably the manuscript. Manuscript, that is to say, things written with pen or something like a paper. Come pretty late, the oldest piece of writing on a paper is a spreadsheet, as Tim O'Neill points out, from around 4600 years ago. We don't know how long manuscript writing had been going on at that point, though it's safe to say that it was already well established. Writing on more durable substances survives longer. For systematic pictographs used as part of what looks like a routine recording rather than a personal artistic project, the oldest contender is probably Dispilo tablet, a wooden tablet carved with a set of glyphs that was preserved in lake mud for more than 7,000 years. This hasn't been deciphered, however, without more context. It's not provable whether this is true writing, which is unlikely, symbolic record keeping, more likely, or just a decorative motif. There are other records in this category, though not as old. The Winca symbols and the Jiao symbols are also very graphic but pre-literate. By the end of 4th millennium BC, you can find good examples of how pictorial records keeping transformed into real writing in both Egypt and Mesopotamia. Most of this is basically accounting data, 5 jars of oil, ode to X, and so on, and becomes common after about 5500 years ago. By around 5000 years ago, this rudimentary recording system was flexible and complex enough to record full sentences. Anything from poetry to literature to laws and proclamations began to be recorded on clay. There are debates about the priority of different finds, but the oldest continuous literary expression, an actual text rather than an inscription or a label, is probably the Kash Tempelhain from about 2600 BC. And finally came the print. The Chinese invention of print and woodblock printing at some point before the first dated book in 868, the Diamond Sutra, produced the world's first print culture. Hundreds of thousands of books on subjects ranging from Confucian classics to science and mathematics were printed using woodblock printing paper, and woodblock printing were introduced in Europe in 15th century, and the first printed books began appearing in Europe. Chinese movable type was spread to Korea during the Joseon dynasty. Around 1230, Koreans invented a metal type movable printing, which was described by the French scholar Henri Jean Martin as extremely similar to Gutenberg's. East metal movable type was spread to Europe between the late 14th century and early 15th century. The invention of Johannes Gutenberg's printing press in 1450 greatly reduced the amount of labor required to produce a book, leading to a tremendous increase in the number of books produced. Early printers tried to keep their printed copies of a text as faithful as possible to the original manuscript. Even so, the earliest publications were still often different from the original. For a short time, in some ways, manuscripts still remaining more accurate than the printing books. Hand-copied illustrations were replaced by first woodcuts. Later, engravings that could be duplicated precisely, revolutionizing technical literature. China, Japan, and Korea developed the earliest kind of print technology, which was a system of hand printing. Books in China were printed by rubbing paper from AD 594, and both the sides of the book were folded and stitched. China, for a long time, was a major producer of printed material. China started conducting civil services exam for its bureaucrats, and its textbooks were printed in vast numbers. Print was no longer confined to scholar officials. Merchants used print while collecting their trade information. Reading became a part of leisure activity, and rich women started publishing their own poetry and plays. This new reading culture attracted new technology. In the late 19th century, Western printing techniques and mechanical presses were imported. No one knows when the first printing press was invented or who invented it, but the oldest known printed text originated in China during the first millennium. Now, how the print reaches Japan? Buddhist missionaries from China introduced hand printing technology into Japan around 768 to 770. The oldest Japanese book printed in 868 is the Buddhist Diamond Sutra. Pictures were printed on textiles, playing cards, and paper money. The Diamond Sutra, a Buddhist book from Dunhuang, China, from around 868 during the Tang Dynasty, is said to be the oldest known printed book. Diamond Sutra was created with a method known as block printing, which utilized panels of hard carved wood blocks in reverse. Some other texts have survived from Dunhuang as well, including a printed calendar from around 877, mathematics charts, a vocabulary guide, etiquette instruction, funeral and wedding guides, children's educational material, dictionaries, and almanacs. It was during this period of early printing that rolled up scrolls began to be replaced by book formatted text. Woodblock printing was also used in Japan and Korea at this time, and metal block printing was also developed at same point during that period, typically for Buddhist and Taoist texts. In medieval Japan, poets and prose writers were regularly published, and books were cheap and abundant. Printing of visual material led to interesting publishing practices. In the late 18th century, in the flourishing urban circles of Edo, later to be known as Tokyo, illustrated collections of paintings depicted an elegant urban culture involving artists, courtesans, and tea house gathering. Now, how the print reaches Europe? Marco Polo returned to Europe after exploring China, and along with him, he brought the knowledge of woodblock printing, and soon the technology spread to the other parts of Europe. Gradually, the demand of books started increasing, so booksellers began exporting books to many different countries. But the production of handwritten manuscripts could not satisfy the ever-increasing demand for books. Europe widely started using woodblocks to print textiles, playing cards, and religious pictures with simple brief text. Johann Gutenberg developed the first known printing press in 1430s. Now, Gutenberg and the printing press. Gutenberg was an expert in the art of polishing stones, and with this knowledge, he adapted existing technology to design his innovation. The first printed book with the new system was the Bible. With the adaptation of new technology, the existing art of producing books by hand was not entirely displaced. Books printed for the rich left blank space for decoration on the printed page. In the 100 years between 1450 and 1550, printing presses were set up in most countries of Europe. The shift from hand printing to mechanical printing led to the print revolution. The print revolution and its impact. Print revolution is not only a new way of producing books, it transformed the lives of people, changing their relationship to information and knowledge and with the institution and authorities. A new reading public emerged. The cost of the books was reduced due to print revolution. Markets were flooded with books reaching out to an overgrowing readership, it created a new culture of reading. Earlier, elites were the only one permitted to read books, and common people used to hear sacred text read out. Before the print revolution, books were expensive, but the transition was not as simple as books could only be read by the literate. Printers started publishing popular ballads and folk tales illustrated with pictures for those who did not read. Oral culture entered print, and printed material were orally transmitted. Now, religious debates and the fear of print. Print introduced a new world of debate and discussion. Printed books are not welcomed by everyone, and many were apprehensive of the effects that the wider circulation of books could have on people's minds. There was a fear of spreading rebellious and irreligious thoughts. In 1517, the religious reformers Martin Luther wrote 95 theses criticizing many of the practices and rituals of the Roman Catholic Church. His textbook, printed copy, led to a division within the church and to the beginning of the Protestant Reformation. Print and dissent. In the 16th century, Minocchio began to read books available in his locality. He reinterpreted the message of Bible and formulated a view of God and creation that enraged the Roman Catholic Church. Minocchio was hauled up twice and ultimately executed. From 1558, the Roman Church began to maintain an index of prohibited books. Now, there was this reading mania. What was it? In most parts of Europe, literacy rates went up through the 17th century and 18th century. Schools and literacy spread in European countries, due to which people wanted production of more books. Other forms of reading, mainly based on entertainment, began to reach ordinary readers. Books were of various sizes, serving many different purposes and interests. From the early 18th century, periodical press developed, which combined information related to current affairs with entertainment. Journals and newspapers carried information related to wars, trades, and development in other places. Isaac Newton's discoveries were published, which influenced scientifically minded readers. Tremble, therefore, tyrants of the world. Books were considered as a means of spreading progress and enlightenment by the mid-18th century. According to Louis-Sébastien Mercier, a novelist in 18th century France, said that the printing press is the most powerful engine of the progress, and the public opinion is the force that will sweep despotism away. Convinced of the power of the print in bringing enlightenment and destroying the basis of despotism, Mercier proclaimed, "Tremble, therefore, tyrant of the world. Tremble before the virtual writer." With this, we come to the end of part 1 of this video. Let's try to analyze what information have you extracted out of today's session. On your screens, you can see a question followed by 4 options. You have to pick the correct option. So let's get going. Where did the development of print first begin? Was it in East Asia, Europe, India, or America? Option A is the correct, East Asia. In which countries was the earliest kind of print technology developed? India, England, China, Japan, and Korea, or Malaya? Yes, it is option C, China, Japan, and Korea. Very good. How were the books in China printed? Option A, printing by seals. Option B, by rubbing paper against the ink surface of wood blocks. Option C, machine printing. Or option D, rust printing. The correct option is option B, by rubbing paper against the inked surface of wood blocks. Very good. How were the books bound in China? Sealed together with glue, machine bound, folded and stitched at the side, were not bound, just put together. This is option C, folded and stitched at the side. Moving on, which country was a major producer of print material for a very long time? Was it Korea? Was it China? Japan or India? The correct answer is China. Good going. Okay. Since China possessed a huge bureaucratic system in the imperial state, how did they do recruitment of its personnel? Through civil services examination? Through verbal interviews? If somebody knew someone in the bureaucratic system? Or direct choice of the royals? The correct option is option A, through civil services examinations. Advent of printing was a revolution in itself. How it impacted the society, how it became an integral part of French Revolution. We shall be doing it in the next video. We'll be back with another video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep studying. Namaskar.